study out of UC San Diego Scripps Institution of Oceanography is confirming the kind of toxins the Tijuana River is releasing into the air. Our Jamie Chambers spoke with one of those researchers and joins us from La Jolla tonight with their findings.
It's in the water, it's airborne, and it's getting people sick. The Tijuana River is not just a nuisance, it's a health hazard. That's according to a newly peer-reviewed finding published in the journal Science.
It's the paper that will drop tomorrow at 11 a.m. in Science. And it's focusing, as was mentioned, on how river pollution is actually affecting air quality across all of San Diego.
Scientists from UCSD's Scripps Institute of Oceanography, in collaboration with SDSU and UC Irvine, have been studying the alarming hydrogen sulfide off-gassing from the toxic waste wafting from the untreated waste flowing from the city of Tijuana down the canyon into the city of Imperial Beach.
In red, I've overlaid the odor complaints. And what you see is they track with a correlation of 0.92. One would be perfect. I mean, basically the community was acting as the sensors, but unfortunately they were not being heard.
The new study found the smells from the waste are the biggest alarm and help identify when the air is most toxic. The team of researchers say officials discouraged their findings, but these scientists pushed on.
We had pushback of people, you know, sort of saying if you tell people it's in the air and they're breathing it, then you're gonna scare the public. We never scared the public. The public was grateful that it finally, because they've been feeling the effects.
Scientists say their newest paper should dispel any doubts that the smells coming from the Tijuana River Valley, especially during the dry season, are harmless.
This is a toxic gas, and so are all the other. Now we've determined there's over 1,000 other gases that are coming out. Many of those are toxic, and they don't even have smells. What this means is it's not a river at this point. Most of this is actually this industrial waste and raw sewage that's making its way through the community.
All right, Jamie Chambers for us tonight.